sorry. What was that?
Allergies?
Welcome to Watch Mojo, and today we're counting down our picks for the top 20 actors who hate their own movies.
Why are they still going to high school? Like up until last year, doesn't they're 100 years old.
We're just here to use the bathroom. Then we're just gonna leave. I hope that's okay.
No, this is just a bad dream. I'm gonna close my eyes, and when I open them, everything will be back to normal.
For this list, we're looking at actors who have reportedly publicly voiced their dislike for a film in which they starred, expressed regret about taking a certain role, or outright criticized their own film. Which actor were you surprised to see on this list? Let us know in the comments below. Number 20, Christopher Plummer, The Sound of Music. It may be considered one of the best musicals or really one of the best movies ever, but Christopher Plummer did not feel the same.
Congratulations, Max. Who will you be exploiting this time? Aha!
Over the years, the Oscar-winning actor did not look back fondly at his role as Captain Von Trapp, the head of the singing family in this musical drama.
Edelweiss, every morning you greet me.
Instead, he made remarks calling the film, quote, so awful and sentimental and gooey. He even went as far as to dub the movie The Sound of Mucus. Ouch.
Oh, how clumsy of me. I meant to accuse you.
He also avoided cast reunions for a while, though in 2010 he did come around and appeared with the full cast on The Oprah Winfrey Show.
But the best part is I got to stay in the hotel with Christopher Plummer. I was an adult.
What room were you in?
Number 19, Charlize Theron, Reindeer Games.
Maybe you saw me and I didn't.
Charlize Theron boasts a strong cinematic resume, having starred in such critically acclaimed films as Monster, Mad Max Fury Road, and the action-packed Atomic Blonde. Sadly, Reindeer Games cannot be counted among them, and Charlize Theron knows it.
There's no future for people like you and me, Nick.
When speaking with Esquire in 2007 about this crime thriller, released in 2000, and co-starring Ben Affleck, Theron didn't hold back, stating matter-of-factly that, quote, Reindeer Games was not a good movie, but that she did it because she loved John Frankenheimer. She also told the magazine that she considered it to be the worst film she'd made to date. Given that the film was a critical and commercial flop, Theron is not alone in having that opinion.
I'm in this too. And I'm really scared.
Number 18, Mark Wahlberg, The Happening.
Let's just stay ahead of the wind.
Every actor used to want to sign up for an M. Night Shyamalan movie in the hopes that it would have an amazing twist like The Sixth Sense. Unfortunately, these days, the twist is usually that the movie you're in might not be good.
Maybe he's onto something.
Still, we can't blame Marky Mark for taking this role. He played against type as a science teacher in the critically panned flick, which, it's worth pointing out, holds a 17% rating on Rotten Tomatoes. Wahlberg has publicly stated that Amy Adams, quote, dodged a bullet by declining Zooey Deschanel's part.
Are you joking?
SNL had a field day making fun of his role and came up with the now viral and superior Mark Wahlberg talks to animals sketch.
Hey dog, how's it going? I like your fur, that looks really great. So you're a dog, right? What's that all about?
Number 17, Michael Caine, Jaws, The Revenge.
Sweet Jesus, they're heading straight for it. Come about, Ellen.
Another true thespian, another serving of unabashed regret about taking a role in a genre film. Unlike Guinness, however, Sir Michael Caine has every reason to regret his involvement in the fourth Jaws film, which by all accounts was no Star Wars.
First time's the best for everything. After that, you know too much and nothing's ever quite the same.
Though the Jaws franchise began with a roar, its success giving birth to the very concept of a summer blockbuster, the series ended on a whimper in 1987 thanks to this embarrassing final installment, which holds a 0% on Rotten Tomatoes. Of the film, Caine boldly once stated, quote, I have never seen it, but by all accounts, it is terrible. However, I have seen the house that it built, and it is terrific.
Bloody hell.
Get us started, double time.
The breath on that thing.
Number 16, Hugh Grant, 9 months.
Seriously? Adam,
what?
My water broke.
Well, we'll get you another.
Water broke.
It wasn't the movie itself or the working experience that made Hugh Grant regret this role. He played a character perfectly in his rom-com wheelhouse as a man-child who's forced to settle down when he gets his dream woman pregnant.
I'm pregnant.
So what's the problem? Grant regrets having done the movie because it was a 20th Century Fox film, a company owned by media mogul Rupert Murdoch.
Well, thank you, cummy bastard!
Shut up, you lighted bitch!
After the News of the World newspaper scandal in 2011, in which the Murdoch-owned newspaper was accused of phone hacking and other shady practices, Grant wanted nothing to do with Murdoch's businesses ever again. So far, he's stuck to his morals.
Well, it's nice, and I think you're great.
Marry me, Captain Ronaldo.
Number 15, Sam Worthington, Clash of the Titans.
Is it true? The son of Zeus.
In the lead up to the sequel, Sam Worthington got candid about the first film, acknowledging that, box office performance aside, it, quote, kind of let down some people. In 2012, he went further into detail, saying that he wasn't happy with what he did on the movie, that he failed to deliver a character, and instead turned in a performance as the, quote, generic bland action dude. In fact, he went so far as to compare himself to a Barbie doll.
I'd rather die in the mud with those men than live forever as a god.
Not just criticizing himself, however, Worthington indicted all parties involved, challenging both himself and the crew to try to make a better film with Wrath of the Titans.
What are you waiting for? Burn it!
Number 14, Halle Berry, Catwoman. With X-Men, Halle Berry proved that superhero roles are in her wheelhouse.
You know what happens to a toad when it's struck by lightning?
So when Catwoman came around, she saw it as an opportunity to further prove to the world that women of color can be superheroes.
You're under arrest.
As she told Variety in 2020, however, there were a few red flags early on. Namely, why can't Catwoman save the world like Batman and Superman do? Why is she just saving women from a face cream that cracks their face off?
How does she know all this? Who is she anyway?
Unable to answer those questions, the movie would eventually go down as one of the worst of all time. Halle Berry ended up winning a Razzie for her performance and gave a special shout out to the team at Warner Brothers in her acceptance speech.
First of all, I want to thank Warner Brothers. Thank you for putting me in a god-awful movie.
Number 13, Sean Connery, The League of Extraordinary Gentlemen.
Would you like to learn how to shoot?
A lot of time and energy goes into making a film, so we can only imagine the disappointment of producing a dud. But Connery wasn't off to a good start with LXG. He apparently only took the role as Alan Quatermain because, having recently turned down roles in both The Lord of the Rings and The Matrix movies, he wasn't going to miss out on another success just because he, quote, didn't understand it.
What? I hate getting old.
He was then rather candid about the on-set fights between him and the director, which reportedly verged on physical violence. When asked about the director's absence at the opening party, he said, quote, check the local asylum, and then abandoned acting altogether.
They're indestructible!
No, just armor-plated.
Number 12, Katherine Heigl, Knocked Up.
I'm pregnant.
Goff.
What?
What?
I'm pregnant.
With emotion?
With a baby.
Perhaps one of the most public feuds in recent times between a movie and an actor, Katherine Heigl made waves when she called out Knocked Up for what she saw as its sexist stereotypes.
I love your curly hair. I use a Jew, it's called.
She went on to say that her character was portrayed as a bitch, and the women in it were painted as shrews, as humorless and uptight.
And just because I'm pregnant, I'm not some ruined woman and all romance goes out the door.
Director Judd Apatow and co-star Seth Rogen did not stay quiet, and both have defended the movie over the years.
If anything, the movie is about what idiots guys are and how it drives women crazy.
The feud has not been easy on Heigl, who's had difficulty landing big roles in Hollywood since. Number 11, Channing Tatum, G.I. Joe, The Rise of the Cobra.
When you move him, she's gonna come after you. You know that, right?
The movie industry is not an easy business to succeed in. Before your big break, when opportunity comes knocking, it can be very tempting to sign multi-film deals with studios, because hey, at that point you can't imagine a world where you'd turn down roles. Like so many of his peers, however, early career contracts would come back to haunt Tatum when he was forced to do this Hasbro adaptation.
I'm going to make you very unhappy.
I'm already unhappy.
When speaking with Howard Stern, he told the radio host, quote, "I fucking hate that movie." Well, no ambiguity there. Though he clearly resents having been forced into the role, he admits that it helped his career and the studio could have given him far worse films.
Move and I'm gonna blow her away.
Do it.
Number 10, Sandra Bullock, Speed 2, Cruise Control.
I swear I am never leaving the house again.
She's Hollywood royalty, so it seems like Sandra Bullock can do nothing wrong.
You don't even work on this ship!
Oh god, I've been in worse situations than this and panicking does not help, trust me.
She's made us laugh with Miss Congeniality and made us cry in Gravity, but even Sandra's had a misstep or two along the way.
Oh! Let's take a wrench and dump it into the engine and bust the transmission like a car, because I've done that.
During an interview in which she was asked about a sequel to the 2013 hit The Heat, Bullock was quick to say, no way.
Believable. Unbelievable.
She told reporters, quote, "I've done two sequels. They were horrible."
You know what? I don't know about sequels. I just don't know about them. Mine have not done well.
It's easy to understand why she's not proud of Speed 2, though. Aside from the fact that, you know, it was on a boat and was missing Keanu Reeves, it holds a very low Rotten Tomatoes score at just 3%.
I'm okay.
You're not okay. Stop saying that.
Number 9, Bob Hoskins, Super Mario Brothers. He was a highly respected actor, so Bob Hoskins didn't feel the need to be coy about his dislike for working on this film.
Shut up!
Now, what's with this rock?
When talking to the newspaper The Guardian, a journalist asked him about any career lows, and he replied, quote, "It was a nightmare." He credits the unpleasant working conditions to the married directors, Rocky Morton and Annabelle Jankel, who he said had their, quote, "arrogance mistaken for talent."
This is crazy. We went under the river, but this can't be Manhattan.
After a few hellish weeks of production, quote, their own agent told them to get off set.
Got it. Let's get out of here. Let's hit the bricks.
Hoskins apparently made it through getting hammered throughout production with his co-star John Leguizamo. Yikes. It ultimately earned a measly 15% on Rotten Tomatoes, and was basically critically panned across the board. So, can you blame him?
Strap your belt on, kid. We're going in.
Number 8, George Clooney, Batman and Robin.
This is why Superman works alone.
George Clooney may be Hollywood royalty, but there's a dark spot in his past. His turn as Batman.
Yes, it's my rules. My rules that keep us alive, and if you want to stay in this house and on this team, you will abide by them.
This is no partnership.
Playing a superhero is pretty much the best thing that can happen to an actor's career, and Clooney did benefit from the name recognition the role gave him, but that's about it.
Nice catch!
You break it, you buy it.
Over the years, he's been known to joke about his work as the Caped Crusader, even saying that he thought they, quote, might have killed the franchise.
I have to say that I actually thought I destroyed the franchise until they brought it back. You know, somebody else brought it back years later and changed it. But, you know, I thought at the time this was going to be a very good career move. It wasn't.
Luckily for us, that was not the case. Though its successful revival wouldn't be until 2005 when Christopher Nolan rebooted the series.
Where are you?
Here.
Number 7, Jim Carrey, Kick-Ass 2.
Catch the strays. Yeah. Oh, and try to have fun. Otherwise, what's the point?
Sometimes current events can affect the way an artist feels about his or her work, and that was the case with Jim Carrey's feelings towards this picture.
Nice party. Anybody want to dance?
When he should have been promoting the film, Carrey tweeted, quote, "I did Kick-Ass 2 a month before Sandy Hook, and now, in all good conscience, I cannot support that level of violence." He went on to say that he wasn't ashamed of the movie or his work in it by any means, but the incident at Sandy Hook Elementary that killed 28 in total caused him to rethink the portrayal of such heavy violence in film.
You know, you shouldn't talk with your mouth full.
It's very rude.
Number 6, Shia LaBeouf and Megan Fox, Transformers: Revenge of the Fallen.
I know you're freaking out. Don't freak out. Don't freak out.
Michael Bay's Transformers franchise might go down in history as the film series with the biggest disconnect between box office success and critical reception. It's a financial juggernaut, but each installment has failed with critics. And any actor who praises the films likely isn't telling the truth.
Wow.
The first movie was at least a fun ride, but when the second came out, even LaBeouf went on record to admit that they got lost, and that without relationships, it was, quote, just a bunch of robots fighting each other. Fox, for her part, said that, quote, people are well aware that this is not a movie about acting.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry about your eye. You know what, but if you're a good boy, then I'm not gonna torch your other eye.
Number 5, Zac Efron, the High School Musical franchise.
It's a class.
Heartthrob Zac Efron upset millions of fans when he decided to put down the franchise that launched him into superstardom, or more specifically, his role in it. Speaking with Men's Journal, he expressed nothing but disdain for his teenage self, going so far as to say, quote, that guy, and that he wishes he could kick that guy's ass, with High School Musical being at the center of his regret. Though fans were pretty quick to pick up arms, you can't really blame the actor. Did you ever let go? Did you ever not know? High School Musical and its sequels were important to a lot of young people, but they were also rather cheesy, and don't exactly showcase Efron's best acting.
Once a wildcat, always a wildcat.
Number 4, Bill Murray, Garfield the movie.
I hate Mondays.
Bill Murray's involvement with this Garfield sequel can be chalked up to a case of mistaken identity.
What part of no don't you understand? The push off the chair? Off! I don't want to play!
In a GQ magazine interview, Bill admitted that he thought the movie's screenwriter was Joel Cohen of the Coen brothers.
Nobody calls me Lebowski. You got the wrong guy. I'm the dude, man.
What he didn't know was that the movie was written by another Joel Cohen, with an H, and a writer who's made his career by writing family movies like Toy Story, Cheaper by the Dozen, and Daddy Day Camp. Uh-oh. He didn't back out of the movie once he realized his mistake, but suffered through recording his lines like a pro.
Mouse!
No thanks, I'm full.
Well, he got the last laugh when he made a joke about it in Zombieland.
So do you have any regrets?
Garfield, maybe?
Murray did go on to appear in the sequel.
We gotta put an end to this torture.
Number 3, Alec Guinness, Star Wars Episode 4, A New Hope.
Hello there.
To be fair, while Sir Alec Guinness was dismissive of Star Wars, his dislike for the beloved space opera has been blown out of proportion, which is why he still makes the cut, but isn't higher than this. About seeing the film, he actually said,
a sort of wonderful freshness about it, a kind of like a wonderful fresh air.
With time, however, and enduring popularity, it seems that he grew resentful of the movie, which, despite an impressive career, had come to overshadow his other works. Years later, he would, to use his own words, quote, shrivel inside each time it was mentioned. Letters written during filming have also surfaced, in which he referred to it as, quote, fairy tale rubbish.
You must learn the ways of the Force if you're to come with me to Alderaan.
Number 2, Ryan Reynolds, Green Lantern.
Oh, I'm sorry, did I disappoint you?
If at first you don't succeed, try again. It's a lesson that Ryan Reynolds clearly internalized. It took numerous poorly received comic book adaptations before Reynolds finally hit a home run with Deadpool.
Oh, hello.
First came Blade Trinity, which despite a poor reception, Reynolds credits with helping his career. Then came the painful proto-Deadpool of X-Men Origins Wolverine, which he later described as a frustrating experience, and doomed from the start. Green Lantern has gotten the worst of it, however, with the star himself only giving it a, quote, 3 or 4 out of 10, and calling it a victim of the Hollywood process. Thankfully, the charming star is a good sport about all these past missteps.
Beware my power.
Before we continue, be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified about our latest videos. You have the option to be notified for occasional videos or all of them. If you're on your phone, make sure you go into your settings and switch on notifications. Number 1, Robert Pattinson, the Twilight franchise.
You better hold on tight, Spider Monkey.
You might not notice it from his performance in this franchise, but Robert Pattinson is a more than talented actor. One need just look at his work in The Lost City of Z, Good Time, or The Lighthouse to appreciate his acting skills. Unfortunately, they're notably absent in The Teenage Tale of Vampires, Werewolves, and Love, of which its male star has made no secret of his deep hatred.
Can't trust vampires. Trust me.
Pattinson has trashed the series on too many occasions to count.
He's joked about wanting his dignity back, admitted to disliking the script, and has waxed poetic about the problems with his character, Edward, as well as the general plot.
There's a lot of stuff in the Twilight world that doesn't make any sense.
Do you agree with our picks? Check out this other recent clip from WatchMojo, and be sure to subscribe and ring the bell to be notified about our latest videos.